An oil embargo as a result of the Israeli assault on the Gaza Strip is less likely to happen. The world's largest oil exporter, Saudi Arabia, stands firm on not using oil as a weapon to reverse that conflict. The Saudi Foreign Minister, Prince Saud Al Faisal, explains why his country, the top producer of the Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries, OPEC, does not think it's a good idea. At a press conference on January 7th, he said, quote, "The use of oil, especially at this time, is an idea that is at least past its worth. The oil producers who need their income aren't going to do that." As of January 8th, crude oil has reached about $42 a barrel, down nearly $100 from record highs in July 2008, a big loss for countries that depend on oil export revenues. An oil embargo would add to that loss. But apparently, Iran, OPEC's largest producer, doesn't mind that if it means pressuring Israel's backers to end the conflict in Gaza. On January 5th, Brigadier General Mir Faisal Bagherzadeh urged Arab and Muslim member states of OPEC to cut oil supplies to the European and American supporters of Israel. He said oil could be a strong tool to pressure them in the, quote, unequal war in the Gaza Strip. Similarly, lawmakers in Bahrain last week demanded that their government take steps to pressure supporters of Israel, including, quote, using the power of oil, according to the Dubai-based Khalij Times. Oil prices hit a two-week high, over $48 a barrel on January 5th, amid concerns that Israel's assault on the Gaza Strip could involve other Middle Eastern countries that produce a third of the world's oil. Meanwhile, Saudi Arabia is trying diplomatically to defuse the conflict in the Gaza Strip. When asked if his country would contribute to a possible international monitoring force, Prince Saud Al Faisal replied, quote, "If we're asked, we will of course think about it." The Saudi prince, though, says his country is clear about not shooting itself in the foot by listening to Tehran's call for oil embargo. He says, quote, "How could you do that? You stop producing oil in order to put pressure on people, and you suffer as much as anybody else suffers. Oil producers need their abilities to build their countries from this oil."